Good morning. It's me, Christy, and I'm here for your guided shamanic journey. So this morning, I have a little candle lit here. As you can see, it's Mother Mary, and I just love this candle. But I just thought that I would put this here, and we would start with saying a little gratitude prayer and intention and blessings. So let's go ahead and do that. And you, of course, say whatever blessing and prayer you'd like at this time. This is just to say thank you for the guidance that we're about to receive. Okay? Dear ancestors, guides, ancient wise ones, thank you for your time and energy. Thank you for sharing your wisdom with us. We appreciate and are grateful for your guidance as we connect with you in the spirit realm for our highest good. Only love and light is allowed here. Much love and gratitude. Thank you. So now we've said our little blessing. And I haven't done one of these in a while. However, I decided that I was going to go ahead and do these again. And so what I'm going to be doing is the morning shamanic journey. And after I do that, then I'll be pulling a card from the Orisa Tarot, which, if you don't know, is from the seven Orisas from Africa. they are the deities there. For example, I work an awful lot with Oshun, who is the goddess of love and sweet water. So now I do have my coffee this morning, so I have my water as well. However, if you guys need a drink, go ahead and do that before we get started. And if you haven't been on a shamanic journey before, and this is your first time, it's very much like meditation, except for me, my perspective is that it's a little bit more, I think they're more fun. It's more enjoyable because you're guided somewhere and you usually will meet with an ancestor or a guide, and they often give gifts too. So to me, I don't know, they're a little bit more exciting. And the purpose of them is to connect with our ancestors and guides and actually have a conversation with them and ask questions. And sorry, I had to wash my coffee down. All right. And so, be comfortable, but the purpose is to connect with our guides and get advice from them. And as you know, there are spirits in the afterworld, but you are also connecting with your higher consciousness. So let's go ahead and begin. Thank you again for joining me. It's been a while since I've done one of these. So go ahead and get comfortable and just listen to the sound of my voice. That's why I needed to drink some water to clear my throat. So you're just going to listen to the sound of my voice, and you're going to, I like to use the term ebb and flow, let it go. Only take what resonates with you. So if at any time your meditation takes you elsewhere, follow that. That's where you need to be. I am simply guiding you on a path in your mind's eye, leading you to whatever is there for your highest good. So if I say something and you notice, oh, my mind is wandering, it's okay. I'm just your guide, catalyst. And it's up to your soul to discern how long that is. So, thank you. All right, let's go ahead and begin. And you could do a mudra if you'd like. Those are hand positions, right? And this particular one, just put it, taking your fingers and just doing this, is the one for connecting with the universe. This one is for warding off negative energy. Okay, sorry about that. This one is for universe, I believe. Anyway, so we're going to use the negativity one, to ward off negative energy, because we could always use some clearing on that, right? All right, so let's go ahead and get comfortable. And this is actually a very good way to help open up some energy points. All right, let's begin. And normally, you know, you might hear some drumming music in the background. However, copyright issues. So just get comfortable. And we're going to start by taking 3 big, long, deep breaths. As you do that, I'll be speaking certain words. They're just simple keywords. And maybe they will trigger a response or a memory or something for you. Again, remembering ebb and flow, let it go. Only take what resonates with you. Here we go. Let's begin by taking our first big, deep breath. Breathing in peace. And hold. Release. Breathing in light. And hold. Release. Breathing in love. And hold. Release. Imagine tree roots from your bottom or seat going into Mother Earth. As you visualize this, imagine seeing your roots push through the layers of soil. The topsoil, the sand, the clay, the sedimentary, so many layers. Gaia is holding you so firmly within her soil and in her arms. She's so happy that you've decided to connect with her today. She's grounding you and keeping you safe and solid. Thank you, Gaia. Feeling very peaceful, calm. Let's begin. We will be taking 10 steps downward. As we do so, I will be speaking words of affirmation. Remembering to ebb and flow, let it go. Only take what resonates with you. Let's begin. Stepping down now. 10 mysteries. 9 trees. 8 fruits of our labor. 7 harvest. 6 wisdom. 5 elders, for wise counsel, 3, wisdom keepers, 2, declaration, 1, they await you. Let's just take a moment and sit peacefully for just a couple of moments and examine what you see in your mind's eye. Do you see colors, shapes? Do you see images or landscapes? Let's just take a couple of moments in silence and observe these landscapes and be aware of how we feel within our body, knowing that Gaia is holding us safe. Let's do this now. Remembering to breathe. What colors do you see? This feels very warm, like comforting, warm. See colors of yellowish sand, very warm, loving energy, golden. Ah, I see. Just in the distance, there is a light. I barely see it. If this resonates with you, let's begin walking towards the light. Remembering to ebb and flow, let it go. If at any time your meditation takes you elsewhere, that's exactly where you need be. If this resonates with you and you would like to discover what is at the end of the light, let's begin our steps walking there now. In mindful meditation, visualize placing one foot in front of the other as we begin walking towards the light. Let's do this now. Noticing everything along the way that you can. Noticing the soil beneath your feet. Any objects that you may see. Shells, rocks, items. Noticing how you feel as you walk towards the light. remembering to relax your shoulders and calm your mind. Let's continue walking towards the light. Notice how your heart starts to feel warm and aglow with anticipation of what is the light. Notice how intuitively you know what you may come upon. Checking in with your intuition in your tummy. Notice how you're feeling as we become nearer and nearer towards the light. Remembering to breathe. Ah, I see. The light is very near now. Could see images or an image, a shadow in the light. Looks like someone is waiting for us. Let's take a few more moments and continue walking mindfully towards the light. Again, placing one foot in front of the other. Noticing your surroundings. Let's take a few more moments and do this now. I see. There's a guide that is here waiting for us. They seem very grateful for our presence. It's a very loving guide. This guide notices the distance that we've walked to come. If this resonates with you and you would like to introduce yourself to this guide, let's do so now, remembering to give gratitude for their presence and their guidance. Let's do this now. Your guide is so grateful that you have come today. This is a very loving guide. This guide feels very familiar. This guide is very familiar to you. If not now, in this lifetime, in another. However, this guide is very loving. It's a very special guide. Let's take a few more moments of silence and have conversation with our guide now. Let's do this now. Your guide has a message for you. Your guide wants you to truly understand worry. Your guide is asking you to please release worry. It does not do anything for you in the moment. It is energy expelled in vain. Worry cannot change anything. Only inspired action can change things. So your guides are asking you to please take worry and release that to your guides and angels. That way you have more energy to expel on progress, projects, or emotional healing. Ah, I understand, thank you. So your guide is saying that when you worry, it takes energy away from what you could be doing to be productive. And it is the shadow side or the ego that wants to hold you back from progress. So if you are stuck in worry, then your energy is spent there. Thank you, Spirit. I see. Let's take another few moments and conversate with our guides once again. Your guide has much to tell you. Let's do this now. Your guides are asking you to please focus on what makes you happy and focus your energy there. Your guides are asking that you really ask yourself that question. What makes you happy? Do you create? Do you write? Do you hike? Do you help others? What makes you truly happy? Let's take another moment in conversation with our guides. Your guide has a gift that they would like to offer you. If you are open to receiving of this gift, in your mind's eye, stretch out your arms and hands and be open in receiving of this gift. Let's do this now. Oh, your gift is very beautiful. goodness. Take a moment and examine the shape, color, size of this gift. Examine it from all sides. Let's do this now. Such an amazing gift. It's breathtaking. Your guides want you to know that you are simply amazing, that the fact that you are here is a miracle, and that you are beautiful and amazing. Your guides really wanted you to know that. This gift that they offer you, oh, it's a gift of great honor. Oh, beautiful. They give such guidance and wisdom, inspiring us with thought, creativity, abundance. Let's take a few moments of silence in connection with our guide, giving them a gift as well, in gratitude, remembering that in the spirit realm, everything is accessible to you. You may offer your guide anything you like. Let's take a few moments in gratitude now. Your guides are so grateful that you've connected with them today. Your guides are suggesting that you would benefit from creating an altar, and this way you have a constant reminder of your ancestors visually, which will help you remember to connect with them daily. They miss you. What a beautiful exchange of energies. At this time, let's take one last moment and thank our guides for their presence, as it is time for us to begin our journey back to the present moment time. Just take a few more moments of silence and do this now. Lovely. Feeling so at peace, so connected with spirit, so grounded. Let's begin our journey back to the beginning. As we do this, again, we'll be both doing walking meditation, mindfully placing one foot in front of the other. As we do this, remembering and reflecting anything that may have occurred, or any messages you may have received, any signs or symbols or guides that you may have met, reflecting upon all of this. Also noting that if you did not meet a guide, it is okay. Everything comes when it is supposed to. Nothing that is meant for you will ever pass you by. Let's begin our walking meditation back to the beginning now. Feeling very loved, feeling very, very at peace, feeling very refreshed for our day. It's time now for us to begin our steps back up to the beginning of our journey. As we do so, I will once again be speaking words of affirmations, remembering to only take what resonates with you. Ebb and flow, let it go. Let's begin our steps up now. Stepping up now. One. Worthy. Two. Right on track. Three, you are divinely guided. Four, rebirthing, breaking through the chrysalis to the butterfly. Five, learning and expanding. Six, benevolence. Seven, honored. You are highly honored by the spirit realm. Eight, it's time. Be open to receiving. Nine. Joyous heart. Gratitude. Ten. Visualize exactly what you want for your new life. 11. Breathing in deeply. Exhale. At this time, slowly bring yourself back to this moment of awareness. And when you are ready, you may open your eyes. And you may join me. Namaste. Wow, that was amazing. Oh, I hope you guys feel refreshed. That's lovely. No, oh my gosh, I've got our cards here. Let me put my glasses back on. I'm very excited because this actually recorded all the way through. So if the tape cuts, then at least we have the meditation. I believe it's going to go ahead and continue through, though. So that was a very lovely meditation. Your guides are so excited to have connected with you. That was very beautiful. I don't know who your guide was, but wow. I will say that my guide was an angelic being, and that was very loving. I hope that brought you some peace. So let's see what the orishas have for you today. This is the 23rd of March on 22, and I haven't done one of these in a while, so I thought I'd give it a shot again. All right, orishas, what would you like for the collective to know for their highest good today? For their highest good. Anything else, orishas? What would you like for the collective to know for their highest good, please? Let's see what we have. Oh, beautiful. So, very clean and simple and clear message. And again, just so you can see, in case you haven't seen this deck, I don't think I've seen anybody else with it. So these are the orishas, and they are the seven gods in Africa. And your card here is strength. There we go. Strength.